बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स एंड व्यूअर्स। टुडे वी हैव अ न्यू लेक्चर, थर्ड लेक्चर इन थ्योरी ऑफ नंबर्स एज अ रेफरेंस बुक, एंड स्पेशली यू कैन से दैट दिस लेक्चर इज़ प्रिपेयर्ड यूजिंग द बुक बाय थॉमस कोशे, एंड नेम ऑफ द बुक इज़ एलिमेंट्री थ्योरी ऑफ नंबर्स विद एप्लीकेशन बाय थॉमस कोशे। हियर यू कैन सी वेल ऑर्डरिंग प्रिंसिपल। डू रिमेंबर दैट अ सब्जेक्ट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स, यू नो लाइक थ्योरी ऑफ नंबर्स या रियल एनालिसिस और ग्रुप थ्योरी और वेक्टर स्पेस, एनी सब्जेक्ट व्हेन यू ओपन इट, दैट सब्जेक्ट इज कंपोज्ड ऑफ एक्सियम्स, डेफिनेशंस, थ्योरम्स एंड लेमास। दे हैव द सेम रोल एज इन अ बिल्डिंग ब्रिक्स, सीमेंट्स एंड सैंड एंड वाटर एंड स्टील। Like these things make a building, so axioms, definitions, theorems, lemmas make a subject. The Velardring principle is very important principle, and it is like, you know, it has a very big application. You will see either in this lecture or in next lecture. It states that every non-empty set of positive integers has a least element. That is, every non-empty set of positive integers has a least element. For example, if you take the set of positive integer 17 and 23, 5, 18, 13, of course this is set of positive integer, and of course what is the least one of them? Yes, 5. 5 is the least one. So this Velardring principle says that every set of positive integers has a least element. Now this is very basic idea, basic axiom, but it has, you know, many applications in maths and, you know, in real world as well. Here we have a theorem. What this theorem says? Prove that there is no positive integer between 0 and 1. What? Of course, this is so simple. We know that there is no positive integer between 0 and 1. We know that there is no positive integer between 0 and 1, but maths, you know, maths requires proof. Prove that there is no positive integer between 0 and 1. So we prove this theorem, and we use contradictory approach. Now, to prove a theorem, there are many approaches to prove a theorem, but in this theorem we adopt contradictory approach to prove this theorem. Suppose that there is a positive integer. In contradictory approach, do remember that we assume wrong. We assume something wrong. And we do calculation and we carry on. And at the end, we get some absurdity. We get contradiction. Suppose there is a positive integer a between 0 and 1. That is, we suppose something wrong. We suppose there is a positive integer a between 0 and 1. Let us design a set S containing those positive integers which lie between 0 and 1. Then of course S is non-empty. Why? Because we have assumed A is a positive integer between 0 and 1, so S contains at least A, so S is non-empty. Since 0 is less than A is less than 1, as we have assumed that A lies between 0 and 1, so A belongs to S, so S is non-empty. Therefore, by the Velardring principle, by this principle, every non-empty set of positive integers has a least element. So by that principle, therefore by the Velardring principle, S has a least element, and let us call that least element L, where of course 0 is less than L is less than 1. Why? Because S, all element of S are in the range 0 and 1, so L is the least element of S, so L is also in the range 0 and 1. Now simply multiplying L in this inequality, as L is, so 0, L square and L. So L square also belong to S. Why? Because L square also lies in this range, and L square is integer, positive integer. So by definition, L square also lies in S. But L square is less than L, which contradicts our assumption that L is the least element of S, because we found less than least, which is not possible. A contradiction. Thus, This contradiction arises due to Arhant's supposition that there is a positive integer a between 0 and 1. Thus, there are no positive integer between 0 and 1. So here you have seen application of this axiom in this theorem. But do remember this axiom has, you know, very beautiful applications which are, you know, coming in this lecture and in other lecture as well. Inshallah. The Velardring principle can be extended to whole numbers also, as the following example shows. Now what it means? It means that if you see, Velardring principle says that every set of positive integers has a least element. But this axiom can be extended to whole numbers as well. You know, in whole numbers we have zero. Do remember that this, for positive integer, but we can extend to whole numbers as well if there is a zero in the set as well. Let's see how. So we extend the above axiom in a form of a theorem to whole numbers. Prove that every non-empty set of non-negative integers has a least element. So we prove this theorem by cases. Let S be a set of non-negative integers, like you can say whole numbers. Case number one. Suppose 0 belong to S. Since 0 is less than every positive integer, so 0 is less than every non-zero element in S, so 0 is least element in S. So proved in this case, because S has a least element. Case number two. Suppose zero does not belong to S. So then S contains only positive integer. So by the Velardring principle, S contains a least element. Thus in both cases, S contains a least element. So theorem is proved. Okay. Now we move to theorem number three. This theorem is very beautiful and it has application in mathematical induction, and you will love that. But anyhow, we need to prove first of all this theorem. This is very beautiful theorem, and you know, it is very simple as well, but it has applications, you know, in number theory. You will see in this lecture or in next lecture, it has applications as well as it has applications in the real world. So let's move to prove this theorem. The following theorem is the cornerstone of the principle of induction. Actually, principle of induction is a technique which is used to, you know, this is actually a technique to prove a formula for positive integer. But this theorem is, you know, the one we are going to prove is going to help us in principle of induction. Everything will be clear to you. Let S be a set of positive integer. That is, let S be a set of positive integers satisfying the following properties. Number one belong to S, and number two, if K is an arbitrary positive integer in S, then K plus 1 belong to S, then S is equal to 1, n. What it means? It means that if you have a set of positive integer such that set of positive integer contains 1, and number two, if you take any number in that set and you add 1 with that number, and if that new number is also in that set, then actually S will be set of natural numbers. It says that actually set of natural number is the one who has this property, that it has 1, and if you take any of its number and you add 1 with this, so the new number belongs to S. Proof. We will prove this theorem by contradictory approach. That is, we will assume something wrong. Suppose S is not n, and let S prime is equal to, of course here, you know, n is the largest set of positive integer and S is any set of positive integer. So here ground set is n. Do remember that when ground set, universal set is n in case of positive integer, so complement of this S, this is any set of positive integer, of course it will be then smaller than n. So complement of this set S will be, what is the definition of a complement? it will contain all those natural numbers which are not in S. Since S complement is not empty. Why? Because you have assumed S is not equal to N. When you have assumed that S is not equal to N, so of course S complement will be not empty. By the well-ordering principle, S complement contains a least element L prime. Why? Because S prime is non-empty and it is a set of positive integers. So by above well-ordering principle, S prime will contain a least element L prime. Then L prime is greater than 1. What is the reason? What is the reason L prime, which is the least element of S prime, why it will be greater than 1? Because here you have assumed that 1 belong to S. When 1 belong to S, so 1 will be not in S prime. So L prime will be greater than 1 because 1 is the member of S, not S prime. By condition 1, S contains 1. Since L prime is the least element in S prime, so if you subtract 1 from it, it will be not in S prime because L prime is the least. So L prime minus 1 will be not in S prime. Therefore, if it is not in S prime, it will be in S. Consequently, by condition number 2, if we add something with this, then that will be also in S. So this plus 1 is actually L prime will be in S because S has the property that if you choose any element and you add 1 with that, it is also in S. S is the set having this property. So by that property, this element plus 1 is L prime will also be in S. But this is contradiction. Why? Because L prime is the element of S prime. It cannot be in S. And of course, this contradiction arises due to our wrong supposition that S is not equal to N. So we are obliged to accept that S is equal to N. Okay. So thank you very much. If you have any question in this lecture, you are welcome to ask.